everybody. It's Becky from the Y. I am a group fitness and small group instructor here at the Y. And today I'm going to lead you through a Pilates bar class. For this class, we're going to use a chair because most of us probably don't have a ballet bar in our home. You could also use something sturdy. You do want your chair to be sturdy, not something that swivels. And you can use a table, countertop, a wall. And I will show modifications. So this is a good class if you're a beginner, if you've done bar before, you know how to change it up to make it a little more challenging. So with that said, I'm going to use a mat also for when we go to the floor. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started. Just make sure you have a little space. We're going to warm up. I'm going to place the hands on our hips. And we're just going to start to open the hips. Now, I like to do bar with my bare feet, or I have socks on. You can wear shoes. A lot of people prefer to keep shoes on. So, if you need that support, that's totally fine. All right, now we're going to keep our feet turned out. We call this first position. So our inner thighs are zipped together, heels are together. And we're just going to lift and lower the heels, rising up on all 10 toes. Okay? Pressing up. So right off the bat, if you didn't need your chair, just have it close by for balance. Four more slowly. Pressing up through the balls of our feet. Okay, we're going to pick up that tempo. Eight quick. Eight, seven, four, three, two, one. Lower the heels. Now we're going to take one foot out to the side. Bend the knees. We call this a plie. So we have equal weight on both legs. And then we're just going to pull back to first position. So we step out second position, pull back first position. Little faster now, warming up those legs. Plie and pull. Now if you had shoes on, you might want to be careful if you're sliding in. Just watch you don't get your foot stuck. Okay, I'm going to add a little arm motion. Just going to open and close my arms. Just kind of following that leg. We'll do four more. And we're going to go right to the other side. Okay, let's step out with that other leg. Out and in. Step out, plie down. Keeping our chest lifted, our eyes looking forward. Three more. Now let's hold this last one in second position. Hold here. Okay, we're just going to do little demi-plies, small plies. Again, our chest is up. So let me turn to the side. Shoulders are over our hips. Neutral lower back, so watch that you're not tucking or overarching. You're just neutral. Eight more. Four. Now make sure your feet are nice and wide. We're just going to shift side to side. Little shifts. Arms reaching. We're going to pick one side and just sweep the arm across. Across. Same arm. Same side. Four more. Three. Two. Now take that arm up. And make a little circle. Up and circle. Back across the chest. Four, three, two. Up and over, circle. Four, three. Are you ready for a quick switch? We're going to take the other arm across at shoulder height. Ready? Other side. Just switched it up a little bit. Arm up and circle. Up. Circle. Feel that stretch through your side. Let's go back at shoulder height. Open up that upper back. Three. Two. Up and over, circle. Two. One. Now I'm going to turn to the side, but you can face forward and take one leg back if it's easier for you to see me. Okay, so I have one leg in the back. Just going to lift and press through the heel. Lift and press. Lift and press. And just making sure I'm warming up my ankle. Now press through that heel and hold. We're going to bring the arms up. If this is uncomfortable on your back, take your arms a little lower. So we're pressing the heel down and opening up the front of our hip at the same time. A little stretch. And now shifting our weight back, let's lift our toes and lean forward. Round your back, roll up. And I'm going to turn the other way, or you can just simply switch legs. Heel, press, lift, press. Pushing that heel toward the floor. Breathe. Two. Press the heel down. Chest is up. I'm going to lift my arms, but again, if this is too much on your back, take your arms lower, or you can even keep the hands in prayer position. Shifting back hamstrings. Now facing forward, feet wide, round your back. Round and arch. Head and tailbone up. Tuck and lift. Head and tailbone. Round. Release. Round. Stay right here. Going to take one shoulder toward our opposite leg and rotate. Look back. Switch other shoulder. Twist. Back to center, roll up. All right, we're going to walk the feet in, and we're going to head to our bar, which is a chair. Okay, so bar is here. Just for a little bit of balance, try not to lean on it or overuse it. Light touch on that bar. We're about arm's length away. And we're going to open up our hips again here in our first position. Okay, now I'm going to come up on my releve. So you can see my heels are up. At any time, you can have your heels down through any of this section. So don't feel you have to be on a releve. We're going to go into a plie. And I'm going to turn to the side again so you can see my body position. Okay? So I'm staying in that upright position. Careful that you're not doing like a fitness squat where you're sitting back. We're nice and tall. Focus on the inner thigh, zipping them together. Now here is what it looks like with the heels down. Okay? So you choose. We'll do four more. Three. Two. Now we're coming down in our plie. We're going to hold the plie. So we have a little diamond shape in between our legs, and we're going to pulse. So this is what it looks like with my heels up. This is what it looks like with my heels down. And as you're going along, like I could tell with my heels down, I don't need the chair at all. Feel free to challenge your balance. Let go of the chair. I bet you don't need it as much as you think. Now watch, what comes next? Our leg that's closest to our support, whether it be a chair, table, that's our support leg, okay? The other leg is the leg that's gonna be moving. So let's take our outside leg and step it out, and now we're in second position pulsing. Again, the heels can be down, the heels can be up. All right, so releve heels up or flat heels down. All right, so we are now in second position. Equal weight on both legs. Let's step it back together, heels together, whether you're flat or on a releve. So what we're going to do is play with the count. Step out, pulse in second, step in, pulse in first. Ready? Step out for 8, 7. With the chest lifted, four heels could be up or down. Now step back to first position, heels together. For 8, 7, 6. Nice and tall, 4. Let's try it again. Step out for 8. Step out. Equal weight. So watch you're not here. You're equal. Put my heels up. Bring those heels together. They can be lifted. They can be down. But we're in first position. Okay, we're going to cut this down. Second position for 4 counts. 4, 3. Heels together for 4 counts. 3. Step out 4. Step in 4. Heels together. Well, let's do 4s one more time. What the heck? 4, 3. Heels together. Now we'll cut it to 2. It's 2 out, 2 in. 2 out, 2 in. Stay in that plie. Out for 2. In for 2. Out for 2. And in for 2. We're going to do doubles 2 more times. Then we're going to go for singles. One more double. Are you ready? Let's go out and in. Single count. Focus. Find a focal point. Concentrate. 4 more. 4. In. 3, 2. All right, let's step out to our second position. Wide. Plie. Lift. Okay, my heels are down. I'm going to add a releve as I come up out of my plie. Plie releve. If you needed the chair, that's why it's there. But don't make it look like this.
two.
Now heels down, demi-plie. We're going to play with the relevance. We're going to keep doing this demi-plie. If you want to do the whole thing with the heels down, totally fine. You're still going to work your inner thighs. You're still going to work your glutes, hamstrings, quads. But if you like, let's try on a relevance. Heels up. Six. You can have one hand on the chair. Three. Press the heels down. Eight. Seven. Six. Keeping our chest up. If you like, now releve for eight. Six. Four. Cutting it to fours. Heels down. Press through those heels. Releve. Think of sinking your sit bones toward the floor. Let's do fours again. Heels down. Releve. One more set of fours. Four. Three. Releve. Cutting it to twos. Heels down. Two. Heels up. Two. Down two. Remember, you can always just keep your heels down if you like. Two more sets of doubles. Releve. Press through. Releve. Get ready for singles. Now just stay low. Stay low. Down. Up. Down. Down. Up. Down. So I'm not bobbing. Okay. Oh boy. I can feel that. Down. Up. Down. Up. Eight. Seven, six, five. I see an end in sight. We are going to finish with demi-plies, either flat or on a releve. So hold your releve or heels down, pulse it out. We have 16, and we'll be there before you know it. Hang in there with me. 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Woo! The heat. Hold, balance, balance. Five, four, three. Oh, I'm shaking. Okay, heels down, forward fold. Stretch it out, shake the hips. Oh, mercy. Okay, walk your feet in, toes heel in, roll yourself up. Go to the other side. I'm just gonna do this. Okay, arms length away, turn out the hips. Heels can be up, heels can be down. First position, this plie extend. Plie extend. So let's just get our position again. If you think of your back being against a wall, okay? And you're just sliding yourself down and up that wall. So the back of your head, your shoulder blades, your hips, they're against that wall. Okay, I don't think I added the flare on the other side. I was too busy talking. But here's a little flare for you, if you wanted to throw that in. We'll do four more since we just added that fun little arm movement. Okay, here we go, demi-plie. First position. So you recall we did this on the other side, so we're going to do it on the both sides. Let's step out second position on a releve or flat. Equal weight on both legs. Heels together, first position for eight. Now we are doing pulses, but try not to bob so much. Pretend you got a glass of water on your head. And you're trying really hard to keep it balanced. Step in, first position for eight. Four, drawing your abs, helps you balance. Step out. Equal weight distribution. Bring it in. Four, three, drop the shoulders. And squeeze your shoulder blades in. Open up the chest. Bring it in. Let's cut to 2 pounds. Two, in two, out, in, out, in. Get ready for those singles. Okay, single count, out and in. Out, in, out, in, out. Five more. Four, three, woo. Second position. Plie here. Keep your heels down for now. So make sure if you're going deep in that plie that your feet are wide enough. So we don't want to go in a deep plie and have our feet close together. That's going to be hard on the knees. So if you have the ability to go low, make sure the feet are wide. Knees stay over ankle. ready? Heels down, heels up. Okay, now can you go a little deeper? Maybe. Four more. Three. Two. All right, and hold the plie, heels down. Pulses. You can stay here, pulsing both heels down, or we're going to switch it up. Do some with one heel up and then the other heel up. So choose one and lift that heel for eight, seven, six. Keep the chest up. Four, other heel, switch. Eight, six. Oh, I think we're going to do another set of eights. Let's go. Eight, seven, six. Try to sink a little deeper. Other heel for eight. Shoulders down, chest open. Okay, take it to four. Switch the heel. Four. Other side, four. One more set, four counts. Four. Switch it. Let's bring the arms in front. Take it to two counts. Two. Two. Okay, when we get to those singles, remember we're going to stay low. We're still on doubles though for three more. We're going to bring those arms overhead. Fifth position, stay low and just alternate. Switch, 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 switch. Holding that plie. Eight, seven, six. Are your shoulders down? Are you smiling? Okay, pulse, releve or flat. This is our grand finale here for this section. We're not done though. Hang in there, guys. We won't be doing any more plies though. Okay, so that's something. Four, three, hold, hold, hold. You can laugh, I'm shaking. I'm gonna stick with it though. 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 4 forward. Okay, shake out those hips. All right, walk it in, roll up. We're gonna switch it up again. We're gonna do butt mount. So we're gonna be nice and tall for that. This will be a little treat. So we're going to go first position, okay? So supporting leg, standing leg doesn't move. It's the outside leg that moves, okay? You will feel both legs. You will feel that standing leg and you will feel the lifting leg. We are in our turned out first position, light touch on our chair, push up, push up. Now if you can, watch again if you have shoes on that you don't get your foot caught, okay, and twist your ankle. But if you have the ability to push off the floor, go for it. Then you're going to activate your glutes and hamstrings a little bit more. Keep your hand on your hip to keep the hips as even or as level as possible. Because what tends to happen, we try to go for this great big old kick, and then our hips get all funky and out of alignment. We don't need that. All right, lower the toe in front. Now our leg is turned out, okay? So instead of my knee facing up, I'm turned out at the hip. Now I can feel my inner thigh doing more of the work to lift my leg. Okay, again, not too high, it's not about the height. It's about the work in the inner thigh. Now I'm gonna challenge here my balance and try to lift my supporting heel on a releve. Okay, now those of you that are well-versed in barre, you can take that hand off the hip. All right, but if you can tell, if that hip starts to do its own thing, the hand goes back. Four, three. We're going to do some pulses. So your choice to stay on your releve, pulse the leg. Okay, if you've had enough of the releve, the heel is down. Either way, our joints are stiff. Are they? Yours might be. Ankle, knee, hip, and shoulder. Okay, we're tall. Woo! Four, three, two, one, back to first position. Bottom on to the back. Now on this one, we're gonna bend our supporting leg just a bit and counterbalance. So as the leg goes back, the chest comes forward. So let's just do a couple of those slow. Plie, bend the standing leg and come up. Plie, now if you can, you can bring your elbow down, elbow up. Be very careful, you ballerinas out there. We don't want to go into this big old over rotation and that hike in the back. So let's try to keep it square. Okay, let's keep our shoulders and hips nice and square. Let's go to tempo. Brush, first, brush, first, push. Okay, push up. Keep your hip bones facing the floor. Strong support in that standing leg. Four, three, two. Now just lower your toe behind you. We're gonna bend our standing leg. So we're gonna plie. My chair is a good enough height for me. I can put my forearm down, pull my shoulders down and back. Arabesque lift. Okay. Just so you know, I do these all the time and I always feel it more in my standing hip than I do in my lifting hip. I feel it in my lifting hip, but I feel it more in my standing hip. So don't feel that you're doing it wrong because you're feeling it more in your standing hip. You're not. This leg is supporting all of your body weight. If you bend your knee, you're going deeper and almost like a squat. So of course that leg is working very hard. So don't feel you're doing it wrong. So these are arabesque lifts. Again, body is square, shoulder down. If this position is uncomfortable, try right here. The leg isn't gonna go really high. Again, not about the height. It's about the squeeze of the glute. All right, we have two, and we're gonna pulse. Leg does not have to be high on those pulses. Okay, so you can have a low leg. And you wanna work harder, go deeper. But make sure you're shifting back, okay? So there should be no weight at all on your toes. We wanna take the brunt out of the knee, so shift your weight back into your heel, and then that glute is gonna feel it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on up, nice and tall. Rush forward. Now watch. My leg, you have a good angle here, is rushing to a bottom and attitude. So like we did earlier, but now I have a slight little bend in my knee. I don't know if you can see it. All right, that's attitude front. Same idea as what we just did. A little bend in the knee. Standing tall. Nice and tall. Six. Five. Your supporting leg is saying thank you right now. Okay. Take out the brush. Just tap in front. Lift. Low. Adding in the flare. So I added the arm and the releve. You can choose to add just one or none. You can do just the leg lift. Doesn't have to be high. We have that slight bend in the knee, and we're turned out again. Inner thigh work. Inner thigh lifting that leg. Four, three, two. Get ready for pulses. On your releve or flat. And just little lifts. Little lifts. Nice and tall. Challenge that balance. Find a focal point. Ooh, my balance is not there today, but I'm still going to try. Little lifts. Ooh, keep going. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Okay, we're going right to Batmans in attitude rear. So brush, little bend in the knee. The hips are still straight. Careful, you're not opening. Hips are straight. Rush. First, rush, remember tilt the chest and bend the standing leg. Are we ready for tempo? Let's go. Rush, upright, rush, rush. Six, five, four, get ready. Hold this last one, let's hold. Hold, square. Sink, elbow down, connect, lift. So what I mean by connect is connect your ankles and then lift with your glute. Again, not about the height. Try not to use momentum, okay? Nice and square, nice and stable. Okay. Want to challenge your strength, challenge your balance. See if you can ditch the chair, okay? I like ready for pulses. All right, ready or not? Pulse, pulse. You go a little deeper, but remember, shift back. See? Hi, chair. Okay, if you're going deeper, shift back more. Focus now on this glute. This glute is working. Let's focus on this one. Almost there, guys, and we're going to stretch. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Okay, now watch. This leg, bring it around, cross it over, and sit back. You're going to do both legs. I'm right there with you. My standing leg has had enough. Okay, let's switch. And then we get to do all that on the other side. So take a little moment here, stretch. If you need a quick drink of water, grab it. Okay, I'm going to situate myself so you can see me. All right, we're going to try here. So about arm's length away, we are going to do the straight leg, Kambatmans first. All right, so just push up. Leg is straight, okay? So we're going to do front and back, straight leg, and then attitude next. Just to clarify, push up. Keep that hand on the hip. Especially if you have a nice slidey floor like I've got, you're going to want to get kind of, I don't know, fancy and really hike that leg up high. But we want to keep our hips aligned. Two more. Okay, toe in front, lift. Okay, now we can start, we're under a little more control here. We can start to add in our releve. We can start to add in that fancy arm. Okay, if you like. This will challenge your balance. Go ahead. Look side. Look forward. And we always have a side that just seems to be so much more connected than the other side. You just have better balance, usually on one side than the other. Your dominant side. Are we ready for pulses? Pulse. Pulse. Okay, leg is turned out, inner thighs doing the work. Nice and tall. Okay, so let me turn. We are so tall on that standing leg, it's not even funny. So as you feel, you can try to let go. Okay, think lift. Think a string tied to your head, pulling you up to the sky. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to first position. Batman rear. Arabesque position. Standing leg bent, chest tilted. Brush. 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 Okay, nice and straight. All right, depending on the height of the chair. Elbow down, elbow up, but we're not collapsing. Push up. 6. Lift with your hip. 2 more. We're going to hold number 2. Ready? Hold. Hold. Plie. Tap. Lift. Tap. Lift. Another little trick. If you're having trouble with the hip, that hip just wants to roll. Sometimes taking this hand and pushing on your supporting leg, not the knee, the thigh, sometimes that helps. But watch, if you do this, then you don't do this. Okey-dokey, we're still in a neutral spine. You guys that are well-versed, good position. Okay, this one can be a little rough on the lower back. So if this isn't your cup of tea, take the hand here, take the hand here. 2 more. Are you ready? Hold that leg up, pulse it. Going for it. Going deep, going deep. And remember, if you're going deep, where's your weight? Not the toes, right? It's back in the heel. Feel the burn in that standing hip. Now you don't have to touch your hips. Get your mind involved. Are your hips square? How do they feel? Do they feel square? Can we lengthen that lifting leg a little more? Pretend somebody's pulling it. Making that leg longer. Wouldn't we all like to have longer legs? Most of us. Maybe not all of us. come on forward attitude. So that little bend. So this would be our straight Bhagman, this would be an attitude. Bend the knee. Pushing off the floor. Oh, that feels so good. Five, four. Guys, remember, at any time, take a break. This can be a lot for the first time. Lower the toe and lift. So if you're not used to this, take breaks. Sometimes all you need is a little 10-second stretch, and you can jump back in. Don't feel like you're done. Little stretch, pick it back up. Here we go. Relevant. Nice and tall. Think of that wall behind you. Lift against that wall. Three, two, hold and pulse. Pulse. The leg. Not the relevant. You're either up or you're down. The leg is pulsing. Let's keep it here. Find your focal point. See if you can let go of the chair. Eight, seven, six, five, four. Are we ready? Rambhatmans to the rear. Attitude. Push. Push. Bend your standing leg and square your body. Remember, chair is there. Not there to take a nap on. Five, four, three, two. We're holding this last one. Hold. Connect the ankles. Lift. Connect. Nice and square. Standing leg bent. If you need the chair, it's there. If you don't need it, see how you do without it. It's always going to be there if you change your mind. A little deeper now in that standing leg. Feel your glute contract. And we don't want to feel the back, we want to feel the glute. So if you're feeling it in the back, you could be lifting too high. You might even want to try coming this way, standing up straight. Okay? And then just main focus the hip. Okay, not out of control. And then as you get a little stronger, then maybe you can go into this leaning forward position. Two. One, now we're going to hold that leg up and pulse it, and push that hip down. Okay, if it tends to come up here, push it down. That leg is behind us. Okay, think of there's a tree there. You're wrapping your leg around that tree. You can take your arm overhead if you choose. No choice. We'll be right here. Let's keep it going, guys. Keep it going. We're almost done. Eight more. Four, three, two, one. Bring this leg around, cross it, and sit. Oh. Woo. Okay, figure four, open the hip. Other leg. Remember which leg you just did, okay? We are going to be lifting the other one, okay? I don't want to confuse anybody. I'm going to use the seat of my chair. Now, if the seat of your chair is too low, you can do one of these positions, okay? You can even come into this position if you want to, but this is a little bit more of an advanced position. So people that have been in my bar class before, Diane's bar class, you may be totally fine in this position. I'm not going to show this position, but if this is where you want to be, go for it. I'm going to do this. However, another option is to come on the floor. I don't like to go on my knee, but we'll just pretend my knee is on the floor and do it in a quadruped, okay? So basically, we're going to do leg lifts. Lots of ways you can do the leg lifts. Okay, one more thing. Especially if you're in this position, watch that your supporting leg, this one, is not back here, okay? This leg, supporting leg, should be right underneath you. Okay, now I kind of like this position because I feel like we work my upper body. And I don't have to be down on my knee, which I don't like. Okay, so we, even as instructors, we like to change things to help us. And we appreciate when students do that as well. If you ever need to know a modification or a substitution, ask us. Okay? We will figure something out. Okay? And then I like this position too because it really enforces that square upper body and hip position. Okay, I can really focus on staying square. Okay. Now, again, just like we were doing, if I want to work that standing glute more, I go deeper. Lift it up. And be very careful of your head. All right, we will be here a while, so we don't want the head like this, and we don't want the head like this. Okay, whatever is neutral is where your head should be. We're going to pulse the left. Okay, pulse it. Now what I'm doing here is I am pulling back. If you can, go for it. You're going to feel that standing hip. Okay, if you're like, no, you're here. Okay? The leg can be low. You can be standing and doing it. You can be up here, holding your wall, holding the back of your chair. Okay, this is just kind of a finisher here. Just a last blast. Okay, leg is up. Flex. We're going to do a leg curl. Kick. Bend. Push out. Push out. Put the emphasis on the outward push. Push out. Push out. Okay? Like you're giving all the force you have and pushing something away from you. Push it away. Push it away. Four. Three. Now we're going to shorten this. Make it tiny. Little kicks out. Out. Nine, eight, seven. All right, we will lower this knee, bring it side by side with our supporting leg, and lift it out to the side. Out to the side. Okay, fire hydrant. Now my standing hip needs a break, so I'm going to stand up. That pull away thing I did, it worked. So I need to stand up for a few here. You can still be in your forward fold. You can still be in your arabesque or T-arabesque position, stacked. Okay, let's do four, three, two. Now leg stays up, knee in line with the hip. We're pulsing, we're pulsing. This would be one you might want to get in your quadruped. Woo! Pulsing. Remember, if you need a break, always you can take one. All right, I'm debating. Do I want to do karate kicks? What the heck? Drop. We're going to kick. Drop. Kick. Drop. Kick. Drop. Kick. All right, if you need a break, take one. Otherwise, bend. Extend. Bend. Extend. You could be right here. Kick out. Bend. Kick out. Bend. Kick out. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four. This is it. Ugh. All right. The leg that was doing all the kicking, cross it behind your supporting leg. Fold forward. You can use the chair. You can come to the floor. Just stretch out the glutes. Okay, roll up. On your side. So remember your options. Okay, here's your T. Lift up, squared. All right. We are officially started here. Arabesque lifts. Arabesque lifts. You can be here. Since I did this on the other side, I'm going to do it on this side. Doki, shoulders down, head in neutral, bend that standing leg. Okay, now remember, now obviously your chair isn't glued to the floor, okay? Maybe you've got, I won't even say this one. But there are ways. Get creative in your home. call select. Two. All right, lift and hold. So these are very tiny. Very small, very small. Keep the focus in the glute. Little tiny lifts. Eight more, then we'll do that frog kick or hamstring kick. Okay, so we're gonna bend the knee, flex the foot, and push. Push. Bend. Push. Bend. Push. Standing leg is bent. Come on, try to stay with it. Remember, you can always stand up. All right, if you just needed a moment or two to get that standing leg a break. All right, are we ready? Faster now. Rest, rest, rest. Keep it going, keep it going. Push up, push up, push up through your heel. 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1, lower, out to the sides, out to the sides, lift. So our knees are in line with each other, lifting to the side. So watch that the knee doesn't come out in front, it's not back here, it's in line with your supporting leg. How about four more, and then we'll do our little pulses. 3, 2, okay, we have our pulses. Up, 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 up. Hang in there with it. Leg does not have to be high. Just try to keep going. I'm burning 2, 7, 6, then we'll do our karate kicks. We'll be all done. Ready, and kick, down, kick, down, kick, down, kick, down, kick, down, kick. Keep going.
Now, other leg. Okay? So remember your choices.
The leg that's not circling can be bent, it can be extended, or it can be hovered. Here we go. 5, 4, 3. Try to keep your hips even and level. 2. Other way. 5, 4, 3. 2. we get tired, we start to let that upper body do the work. We don't want that. We want our abs to work, right? We're almost done, guys. Almost done. Three, two, all right. Legs lifted. Pelvic tilt. Pelvic tilt. Now my arms are down at my side. My head is down. If you want, try it this way. Okay? Bend and lift. Okay? And then as you get stronger, keep the legs straight. Little bit more challenging because we have no momentum here. Okay? It's the abs contracting that's lifting our hips. If you like, head and shoulders up. Inhale. Exhale. Put your hands on your stomach if you don't believe me. There's muscles there. They are working. They are. I asked my son to do some of this stuff. I said, do you feel your belly muscles working? He's like, what? He's 15. He should know where his belly muscles are by now. Okay, guys, I promise we're going to pulse and we're going to be done. But let's do these pulses. Come on, let's do it. Up. You can be right here. You can be right here. But come on, do this. Lift, 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 lift. Up, up, up. Eight more. Seven, six, four, three. Hold that last one. Four, three, two, one, and that is it. Come on down. Extend your legs, reach your arms overhead, and just stretch. Reach your right arm, reach your right leg, and then the left arm and left leg. One side at a time. Oh my goodness, feels so good. We're going to circle our arms down to our sides, hug our knees into our chest. Take a couple little circles. And then we go the opposite way. All right, bring one foot to the floor. You're going to hold behind the hamstrings or the calf muscles of that other leg. Pull that leg toward you. Okay, if you need to bend the knee a little bit, go ahead. But then try to extend it, push through the heel, and feel a stretch in your hamstrings. Let's go ahead and do another figure four stretch. Cross the leg over your bent leg and pull the knees to the chest. Keep your head and shoulders relaxed on the floor. We're going to switch legs, so we'll bring that other foot down. Hamstring stretch, other side, bringing that leg toward us. Control behind your calf muscles, hamstring muscles. We're going to cross this leg over our bent leg. Pull the knees into the chest. Open up our hips. Okay, bring the legs down. We're going to roll over onto our belly. I'm going to just turn so you're not looking at my feet. Arms at our sides. Lift the head and shoulders. Reach the fingers towards the feet. And release. Again, using our back muscles here. Release. Again, lift. Feel free to stay with this one. Otherwise, we're going to take our right arm overhead, our left arm back. Top palm down, back palm up. Lift up. Now we're going to look over the shoulder with the bottom arm. And we lower. And we lift. And we lower, and we lift. We call this one the surfer. And we lift. We can always imagine, right? Lift, lower. I have a blue mat. It kind of looks like the ocean. I can just pretend I'm on a surfboard in the ocean. Lift. Wherever the water is so clear. I don't know where that is. But that's where I want to be on my surfboard. and release down. We're going to push back into child's pose. My child's pose doesn't look like a normal child's pose because of my knee issues. So if you remember what child's pose is, you go into it, and I will do my variation. Just relaxing our lower back. Okay, from our child's pose, we are going to come into downward dog. So a good way to get into downward dog is from a plank position. Just push your hips back toward the back of the room and push your heels toward the floor. Now let's lift one heel, push the other heel toward the floor. Switch. We're going to step our feet in toward our hands. Round the back, slowly roll ourselves up, restacking the vertebrae, one on top of the next. And then once we're all the way up, we're going to reach one arm up. Feet can be together or hip width apart, leaning to one side. We're going to stretch to that side. Up and switch. Other arm up, lean to the side. And release. And let's take a deep breath. Arms lifting. Great job, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you had as much fun as I did. Well, maybe not as much, but I hope you had a little bit of fun. Hope to see you real soon. Take care. God bless. Bye.